to showcase New York is leading the charge, we've come up with scenarios to demonstrate the capabilities of the test site and capabilities of the vendors that are out there in pushing this industry and working to actually see the reality of drones in the national airspace. We demonstrated the component that will interface to the FAA to air traffic management. So that was the number one piece. The second piece was actually all the moving parts of how drones would be used in a venue like a farmer's market.
Well, I think it's very important for us to participate as a community because we are the home to the UAS test site, one of only seven in the country certified by the FAA. And this was a good opportunity to showcase a commercial application of the drone in a public facility. We had the downtown market happening today, so we had vendors, and we had the public was able to interact with the whole scenario.
We have four separate scenarios. We're flying with four different UAS. UAS one is the event.
An event coordinator needs to use a drone to just kind of oversee the event, make sure things are going smoothly.
It's going to transit over City Hall and it's going to fly a rectangular pattern around City Hall. The second aircraft, UAS 2, is a media aircraft. That's going to take off and go over the top of the apartment building and it's just going to hover.
And then security.
The third aircraft is going to be a law enforcement aircraft. That's going to take off from the ground. It's going to be used as law enforcement, and it's also going to be used to do the ACAS demo.
Sense and avoid. A capability called ACAS. The farmer's market is 5 miles from the Griffiths International Airport. That's significant. It's a towered airport. That is where the test site is. Now, an individual was flying his Cherokee, but with the ACAS on board, the operator was alerted that a plane was approaching, and then the alert goes off, and we demonstrated how, in fact, the ACAS detected the manned aircraft and then did a divert, because the drones have to give manned aircraft the right of way.
Then we're going to put that aircraft on top of the building.
There's going to be variability on where you want the drone to be. It's not just going to hover. So we demonstrated flying from the ground to the rooftop.
Then it's going to be retasked to go and take a look at the water break and deliver an EpiPen. It's going to land back on the ground to get an EpiPen?
Yep.
And then take off and deliver an EpiPen.
We implemented a volume restriction, so the event manager had to land. It gave the emergency medical people access to the space. And the reason why we wanted to do that was we needed to deliver an EpiPen because one of the workers was stung by a bee and was having an allergic reaction. What was unique about that was not only the delivery of the EpiPen, but the ability to fly the drone through a maze of buildings, light poles, and trees. So we demonstrated obstacle avoidance hardware and software. So we leveraged the obstacle SDSP to provide the data to the hardware on the platform so that it could maneuver around the buildings, around the light poles, around the trees, and actually deliver the EpiPen.
Somewhere in the midst of all of this, the fourth aircraft is an intruder.
We issued a UAS volume restriction, and what that means is if law enforcement or emergency medical people need to use that airspace, the other drones leave the airspace. So remote ID is important because if there's a person who is observing, law enforcement thought it was a safety issue and asked him to land his aircraft. In this event, we were able to demonstrate the use of multiple USSs, drone service suppliers, flying from a remote operation center.
I think all three aircraft are ready now.
And you are clear for takeoff.
All right, launching.
We wanted to demonstrate how USSs share information so that there is total situational awareness of the airspace. The New York State UAS test site is leading the charge because of the team that is involved. NUAIR, AX, all the USSs, we're all trying to work together to push the envelope. And together with New York State's investment in developing the test site, creating the infrastructure that enable vendors to truly exercise those technologies that will be key to the integration of UAS in the NAS.